Hello friends, I'm Dr. Vineet Aggarwal. And before we all begin with the celebrations of Dandiya and Durga Puja, I thought of sharing some interesting facts about the festival of Navaratri with you. To begin with, if I ask you how many times does Navaratri fall in the year, most of you would probably say just once. In reality, Navaratri comes four times in the year at the beginning of different seasons. The first Navaratri in the year is that in the month of spring, which is known as the Chaitra Navaratri, which also marks the beginning of the Hindu New Year. This is followed by Navaratri that falls during the months of monsoon, followed by the Sharad Navaratri, which is the most popular one, and then another Navaratri that comes in the month of Magh or the winter season. The Devi Bhagavat Puran mentions that the goddess should be worshipped in her primal aspect of Prakriti or nature at the beginning of these seasons so that she can be propitiated and the diseases kept at bay. Another interesting fact about the Navaratri, especially the Chaitra and the Sharad Navaratri, the two most popular ones, is that both of them are associated with Lord Ram. While the Chaitra Navaratri, that marks the beginning of the Hindu New Year, culminates on the ninth day with the birth of Sri Ram, which is also known as Ram Navami, the Sharad Navaratri is believed to have been started by Lord Ram himself when he propitiated Devi Durga to attain victory over the demon Ravan. The 10th day of this Navaratri is also celebrated as the Sehra, when the Devi granted his wish and he was able to defeat Ravan. The third thought-provoking fact about Navaratri is that each of these 9 days is dedicated to a different form of the goddess. The first day is dedicated to Ma Shailputri, which refers to Parvati as the daughter of the mountains. The second form is of Brahmacharini, which basically shows Parvati attaining the form of a Brahmacharini or a mendicant to please Shiva and obtain him as her husband. The third and the fourth forms show Parvati as a married woman after the attainment of womanhood. The fifth form, known as Skandamata, depicts the goddess as a mother for the very first time. Parvati is shown with the baby Skand or Kartike in her lap, and this is probably the oldest representation of the goddess as a mother in any world religion. The sixth form of the goddess is known as Katyayani, and this is by far the most popular depiction of the goddess. This is the one that is associated with the defeat of the demon Mahishasur and is worshipped all over the world as goddess Durga. The seventh form of the goddess is perhaps the most misunderstood one as well. Ma Kali or Mahakali is the most fierce depiction of the goddess anywhere in the world. If you compare nature as a benign force compared to when it becomes destructive in the form of tsunamis or earthquakes, you would understand the reasoning behind the depiction of goddess Kali as a fierce goddess. Kali also represents the absolute pinnacle of Indian feminist movement, where a goddess is able to achieve what even the gods cannot. After showing the world what she herself is capable of, Kali returns to the demure form of Gauri. Between the two forms, you find an entire spectrum of divinity, where Kali as a wildling and Gauri as a woman who follows social and cultural norms represent the various aspects of feminism that we see around us. The final form of the goddess for the ninth day is that of Ma Siddhidatri. Now, what is interesting is that while all the other forms are different manifestations of Parvati, Siddhidatri is closest to the depiction of Ma Lakshmi. She represents the evolution of a woman from a daughter to a lover to a wife to a wildling to an absolutely divine being. The Navadurga therefore depict different stages of womanhood, and none of them is inferior to another, just as a woman taking care of her home and her children is in no way inferior to one who's pursuing a career outside the home. This Navaratri, let us worship all these divine forms of not just the goddess, but the women around us as well. Jai Mata Di.